There's a new comedy right here in 10, 11 Strong called Empire. This is Dennis Dugan.
Ah! Well, well.
You are, I was just going to say you were the only sane one out of a whole bunch of loonies and kooks. And then if you respond like that, then you make me out as a liar to the people out there watching, because then you don't look sane.
I'm an actor. I have to portray different characters.
Was that what you were doing?
Wear many masks.
Is that called acting?
I think so.
Dennis?
Yes, darling.
Does anxiety really breed excellence?
That seems to me. Yes. Yes, it does.
Whatever you say. We only speak the truth here in Nebraska. Yes. You know how. Listen, I don't know whether you've had a chance to see it. It just recently got started, but I predict it's going to work. You got a whole bunch of zany people. Yeah. They're really, you got some really good support people.
Great.
Each off of whom, you know, a little story will develop, and so you don't have to carry the whole thing.
Right. This is a good group of actors. It's a kind of actors, if you see them all, you know you've seen them all before. You don't know their names, except Patrick McNee. He's the only kind of star. These guys have been around working in plays, working on Broadway, working on supporting parts here and there. So you get in there with these people, and they don't have an axe to grind. They don't have anything to do except the job. And it's real nice it's nice to deal with, like, actors who are acting.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, if the show's a hit, they'll all turn into
demanding
creeps, and I won't want to see any of them. No, it's nice.
People who show up late for appointments and bring their animals.
I find that disgusting.
You are not alone. You are a real
town boy.
Well, Patrick McNee, if you go back a few years, is a really big star. Remember John Steed on the Avengers? Well, he's the guy who's in charge of this whole empire. And everybody's running around in the executive suite being so very much concerned about him. He's a wonderful actor.
Yeah, but they're not only doing that, they're all concerned about themselves. You know, they're afraid he's going to get them, but everybody's there murdering and committing adultery and forcing alcoholism on each other and bribery and anything they can do to get ahead. And that's kind of like life, I think.
This is a tranche de vie,
yes,
slice of life, most definitely. The guy that I am really interested in, he's in your supporting cast. I think he plays Mr. Willow.
Yes, I use company funds to put in a barbecue pit. Electric spit, benches, funny aprons. No, don't try to stop me. I've got to say this. I did it, Ben, and I'd do it again.
Barbecue pit? Jack, you have some catching up to do. That is small potatoes. Now, Everett here, he went for big potatoes. A swimming pool.
Swimming pool?
Swimming pool. Charged to stationary supplies. That's a lot of paper clips, Everett.
Ben, I think you're overreacting.
Roger, I think you're overbilling. Roger here got a tennis court thanks to legal research.
Tennis court?
What's wrong with that? The company built a hydroelectric dam. There's a lot of cement left over. It just happened to fit in my backyard.
Tennis court. Well, if Jackie hears about this.
And for the indoor sportsman, we have a lovely soundproof pistol range built over a garage.
Justified expenditure on the head of security.
You don't shoot people, do you?
Yes, he does, Ben.
Richard Masser. Masser,
yeah.
Masseur.
Yeah.
Did you see him in Fallen Angel?
Yes.
Oh,
he's wonderful.
Fallen Angel was written by a man by the name of Lou Hunter, who used to work at our television station in Lincoln, Nebraska. And now he's a big-time writer out here in Hollywood. And he wrote, this is a story of child pornography. And Richard Masser, who is in Empire, played the role, and he's an extraordinary actor.
Yeah,
exactly. I mean, he's first quality, and here he's willing to play a support kind of person.
Right. But, you know, also, you got to remember, he got the child pornography concession on the set.
Yeah,
so
did he?
So he makes a little less money on the thing, he makes a little more money on the porn. So, what are you going to do?
What, you got shot on, he was on Hill Street Blues.
Yeah.
They shot you off, up?
They shot me with a gun. I hate to tip you
off.
Where? Right in the chest.
Was it a clean?
I was always pre-programmed to be murdered after four episodes because I messed around with bad guys. And the bad guys in this America, you know, this gun-crazy America, if you mess around with those guys and stand in front of their gun, one of them good chance he's going to pull the trigger, and there I was, dead.
You knew the end was coming, right, from the beginning?
Yeah,
cool. I mean, because the show has done so well, don't you wish they could have kept, couldn't they revive you? Look at all the people they've revived.
Oh, they revived a friend of mine who was a horrible, awful drug dealer, sleazebag kind of character, and they sent him away to jail, and what do you know, they've resurrected him.
Well, let's see, but if you're dead, what can we do?
Nothing. Dead, dying, gone, history, yesterday's news, in the wind, out of here. a memory, just enough.
Ships passing in the night.
Whatever else.
Dennis is a graduate of the Goodman Theater in Chicago, Illinois, where your mother also went there, right?
Yep.
And obviously, regional theater is important to you and your family. How does it help you grow?
Well, you can go to some theaters and out of like the marketplaces, which is New York and Los Angeles, and you can go and you can play, you know, parts that you normally wouldn't play. Like in Tulsa last year, I played Hedda Gabler.
You were Hedda?
No.
Did you have your dueling pistols?
No, but the audience did.
Oh,
it was interesting.
Good.
No, but it is, it's good to have that kind of theater, especially for us, so you can go and you can take chances, you can stretch, you can play parts maybe you wouldn't play, and also there's wonderful audiences for theater all over the country.
Yeah. Well, that's a good theater there. Hey, we're delighted that you got this leading role.
Oh, sure, it's not as delighted as my mother, but...
And you, and being able to pay the garbage man, and the electric light bill every month?
Absolutely.
Okay, Dennis Dugan, good luck in the show.
Oh, thank you.
He's the sane one. You'll look for him on Empire here on 10-11 Strong. Thank you very much. Please don't go away. 10-11 Morning continues.